Good morning, students. In this video, I shall discuss the different events which occurs during the sexual reproduction in plants and animals. Now, what are the important events normally which occur in the sexual reproduction in plants as well as in case of animals? Now, the important event which occurs is the pre-fertilization event, because the fertilization is the most important event in the process of sexual reproduction. So before the fertilization, before the fusion of the male and the female gamete, some event occurs in the plant as well as in the animal, and some event occurs after the fertilization. So that is why these are divided into three phases. The three events are the pre-fertilization event, which occurs before the fusion of the gamete or the fertilization process. Now, in the next one, that is the fertilization or the fusion of the male and the female gamete. Now, next one, that is your post-fertilization event. So, after the fusion of the male and the female gamete, what sort of changes occur in that particular embryo, or you can say zygote? Then the zygote develop into the embryo, and the embryo later on develop into the new plant. So, that is why these are the post-fertilization event. So now we shall start from the first one, that is a pre-fertilization event. And what are the important events which start here? The first one, in case of plant. In case of plant, normally when they sexually mature, or after the completion of the juvenile phase, normally they enter into the reproductive phase. And during the reproductive phase, the first important event, that is the formation of the flower in the plant. And that is called flowering. And during flowering, the male flower, female flower, or bisexual flower, they are normally start there in the plant. Now, after that, these flowers, they produce the gametes. Either the male flower, they produce the male gamete, female flower, they produce the female gamete. And when it is a bisexual flower, then the stamen produce the pollen grain, then the pistil produce the egg cell. Now, this gametogenesis are of two types. In the male gametogenesis and the female gametogenesis. Male and the female gametogenesis. And the male gametes, which are also called the pollen grain or microspores. So, formation of microspore or pollen grain, in case of plant, it is called microsporogenesis. So, during this microsporogenesis, what happens? The pollen grain, or you can say the microspores, are formed there inside the anther. And after the formation of this pollen grain in the anther, then it will transfer to the stigma. But here, the next one, that is your megaspore or egg cell. Normally, the egg cell or megaspore are nothing but the female gamete. And the female gametes are normally produced there in the pistil, which is the female part of the plant. And this pistil, they develop the egg cell. And the process of formation of this egg cell or megaspore, that is called megasporogenesis. So, after the megasporogenesis, the egg cell is formed there in the pistil inside the ovum. But here, the pollen grains are formed inside the stamen, or that is the anther, you can say more specifically. And now, after the formation of the pollen grain in the anther, and after the formation of egg cell in the pistil or inside the ovary, inside the ovule, inside the embryo sac, we shall discuss in detail in the next chapter. Now, after that, the next important event which occurs in the plant, because the pollen grains are formed in the stamen and the egg cells are formed in the pistil or normally in the female reproductive part. So, that is why the transfer of pollen grains occurs from the anther to the stigma, and that process is called pollination. And normally the pollination occurs through the different agencies. It may be your water, these are the hydrophil flower, it may be your air, and sometimes most important, they are the insect. They normally help in the transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma. So these are called entomophilic flower. Sometimes some animals, they also transfer. Sometimes the birds, and sometimes even the bats. They visit from one flower to another flower, one plant to another flower. So that is why they normally help in the process of pollination. And the process of pollination, we shall study in detail in the next chapter, but it is either self-pollination or it is cross-pollination. when the pollen grain transfer from the or pollen grain transfer from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, then it is called autogamy. So it is a bisexual flower, and the pollen grain from the anther it normally transfer to the stigma of the same flower. That means it is the same flower where it occurs. So that is why it is called autogamy. But sometimes it normally transfer from the anther to the stigma of different flower of same plant. The plant is same, but the flowers are different. It may be a cucumber or cucurbita. So in this case, what happened? The unisexual flowers are there, but in the same plant. So that is from the male plant, from the anther of the male plant or male flower, male flower to the female flower or stigma of the female flower in the same plant. The plant is same, but the flowers are different. Then it is called geitonogamy. Now, in case of xenogamy, normally the plants are totally unisexual. That means, in this case, suppose it is a papaya plant, and in this papaya plant, the male plants are different and the female plants are different. So, from the male plant, it is transferred to the another plant, that is the female plant. So, that is why this process of transfer from one plant to another, from the anther of one plant or flower of one plant to the stigma of the flower of another plant. So, that is called xenogamy. So, in case of papaya, this type of pollination. Okay. Now, these are the pre-fertilization event when the pollen grains are transferred to the stigma. Now, when the stigma is recipient and mature, then the next event occurs, that is the fertilization. But in case of animal, normally when they become sexually mature, that means that is called early stage of sexual maturity, that is called puberty. And during this puberty, and it starts at the adolescent stage, and this is called the maturation phase. And during sexually maturation phase, normally the hormones are secreted in the body, and the secondary sexual character and the primary sexual character, the ovary and the testes, they mature, and the testes, they start producing the male gamete. That process is called gametogenesis. And specifically, the formation of the spermatozoa or the male gamete, it is called male gametogenesis or spermatogenesis. And by this process of spermatogenesis, the male gametes are formed in the testes of male. But in case of female, normally the egg cells are formed in the ovary. So that is why this process is called oogenesis. The formation of the egg cell inside the ovary of the female, that is called oogenesis. Then after the formation of the spermatozoa in case of male individual, and the formation of the egg cell in case of female individual, and now, next is the transfer of the male gamete from the body of the male to the body of the female. This process of transfer is different in the different animal, but normal process, that is the copulation. But during this copulation, what happens? The male gametes are discharged by the male individual into the female genital tract of the female. And after that, the next event, that is the fertilization, occurs in case of animals as well. Now, we shall discuss the next important event, which is the most important event, which occurs both in case of plants and animals. Of course, the pattern of fertilization are different in case of plants and animals. In case of plants, this fertilization process, it is called double fertilization, because the fertilization occurs twice in case of plant. But in case of animal, it is a single fertilization. Now, this fertilization event, what is fertilization? Fertilization is the fusion of male and female gamete. When the male and female gamete, they fuse together, then this process of fusion, it is called fertilization. Now, in case of plant, how this fertilization occur? In case of plant, the fertilization process, it is called double fertilization. It is called double fertilization, because it occurs twice. We shall discuss in detail in the reproduction in flowering plant, but we are giving just highlight of this. And during this double fertilization, the first fertilization, it is also called the syngamy. during this syngamy, what happened? The fusion of, this is the fusion of first pollen or first pollen nucleus with the egg cell. So when the first pollen fuses with the egg cell, then this process is called syngamy, and after that the zygote is formed, and this zygote develop into the embryo later on. So this process is the first fertilization, and the second pollen, it is normally fuses with the second fertilization, then the second pollen nucleus or second pollen, it normally fuses with the diploid polar cell, with the diploid polar cell or diploid polar nucleus you can say, and this diploid polar cell to form a triploid cell, and this is a triploid cell, and this triploid, because the pollen is having the n number of chromosomes, and in the diploid this is the 2n, so that is why here it is 3n, so it is a triploid cell. Now this process is called triple fusion. So the fusion is called triple fusion, and this is the triple fusion. So the first one, the syngamy and triple fusion, these are the two process of fertilization occurs here, and this triploid cell, they normally develop into the endosperm. The endosperm is nothing but the reserve food material which normally supplied to the developing embryo during the embryogenesis. But now, how this fertilization event occurs in case of animal? In case of animal, the fertilization events are little bit different from that of the plant. In case of animal, the animals move from one place to another. Sometimes the animals are aquatic in nature, some animals are aerial in nature, and that is why on the basis of their habitat, their mode of fertilization are also different. So here what happened? Some events which occur there in the outside body, so that is why the fertilization, as we have discussed, the fusion of male and female gamete, and this fertilization when occurs outside the body of the organism. Normally, in case of animals, it is different, and this fertilization when it occurs outside the body of the organism, that is called external fertilization. And normally, in case of aquatic animal, in case of aquatic animals like your frog, the male gametes are discharged into the water body by the male organism, and the female organism, they discharge the egg cell. So frog are normally, the male and the female frogs are there, and the male, female frog first discharge the egg cell, and the male organism, they discharge the spermatozoa over the egg. So that is why the fertilization occurs in water, because both they discharge their gametes into the water body. So this process of fertilization, which occurs outside the body of the male and female individual, that is called external fertilization. And after the external fertilization, the development also occurs externally. So development also external in nature in case of frog. But some animals, well, the fertilization occurs inside the body of the female. So inside the body of female. So that is why this type of fertilization is called internal fertilization. But sometimes what happens after the internal fertilization, the development occurs outside the body. Development occurs outside the body. So that is why it is an internal fertilization and external development in case of oviparous animals. In case of oviparous animals. So oviparous means the animals which normally lay the eggs. So these birds and reptiles, normally the birds as well as the reptiles, normally after fertilization inside the female genital tract, the eggs are formed, and these eggs are now laid to the outside, and outside the body the development occurs, and the hatching occurs outside the body. So that is why the development occurs there inside the egg. So that is why these are called the egg laying animals. These are the egg laying animals. and these egg laying animals are normally called the oviparous animal, and this is called the incubation period. Suppose in case of chick or hen, the chicks are developed in the egg for 21 days. So this period is called incubation period, and this incubation period is 21 days in case of chick. And this period may be different from the different from animal to animal. Now, in some cases, what happens? The fertilization occurs internal, as well as the development of the embryo or development of the new young one. If development occurs, development of embryo normally occurs inside the body of the female organism. So that is why this process is called internal fertilization and internal development. It is the internal development. Both fertilization and development occurs inside the body of the female. And the most common example, that is the human female. In case of human being, normally both fertilization and development of the embryo both occur inside the female's body. And this period of the development of the embryo, starting from the zygote till birth, this is called gestation period. And this gestation period varies from organism to organism. In case of human being, it is 9 months and 10 days. 9 months and 10 days. That means it is 280 days. But in case of elephant, this is having the longest gestation period. It is around 22 months. In case of elephants, it is around 22 months. So that is why the fertilization process, of course, it is different in case of plant and in case of animals, but the fertilization occurs in the sexual reproduction, and it is the most important event. Now, after the fertilization, what happens to the zygote? The zygote is formed after fertilization, both in case of plant as well as in case of animal. And this zygote then develops into the embryo, and this embryo finally develops into the new organism. Now, this development process is different both in the plants and animals. So here, how does it occur in case of plant, and what are the important events which occurs here? So this process of the development of the zygote. Now, after the fertilization, this zygote is formed, and this zygote now develops into the embryo, and this embryo develops into the foetus in case of animal. And this process of development of the embryo, and here in case of animal, the birth occur, but in case of plant, it is totally different. Suppose it is the plant, the double fertilization occurs, and during double fertilization, what happens? The first product, that is the zygote, and zygote is produced by the process of cigamy, and this zygote is now developed into the embryo, and this embryo now gradually develops into the new organism. So this is the new organism, and this development of the embryo, it is normally different in case of monocot and dicot plant. So that is why it is the monocot embryo and the dicot embryo. And this dicot and monocot embryo, they have the cotyledon, and the cotyledon, they store the reserve food material for the developing embryo. Here one cotyledon is there, here two cotyledons are there, and gradually they develop. And now what happens? The zygote develops into the embryo, and the embryo into the new baby plant. Now here, how this ovule of the female flower, it develops into the seed. The seed has the seed coat. The seed contains normally the seed coat, seed contains the cotyledon, and seed contains the embryo. So that is why the embryo develops into the new plant. Cotyledon supplies the food material to the embryo. Then the seed coat, it protects the embryo which is developing inside the seed. Now, this seed is formed, and inside the seed, the embryo is there. Now, the whole ovary of the female flower, the ovary develop into the fruit. And when the ovary develop into the fruit, then this is called the true fruit. And inside this fruit, the seeds are there. But sometimes the fruits are developed without fertilization. It is called parthenocarpic fruit. And sometimes some animals develop, in case of honeybee, without the fertilization, or these are called haploid organisms. So that is called the egg cell directly develop into the new organism. That is called parthenogenesis. In case of parthenogenesis. And this parthenogenesis is the development of new organism directly from egg cell or from egg without fertilization. So normally this process or this type of parthenogenesis occurs in case of honeybee. So in honeybee, the males are normally developed from the egg which are not fertilized. Now in case of animal, how this development process occurs? In case of plant, this type of seed formation and the fruit formation occur, and the dispersal of the seeds occur, and the fruits are normally shedded to the different parts, and this dispersal helps in the survival of the organism. Now in case of animal, normally what happens? The fertilization occur. After fertilization, it is a single fertilization, and this single fertilization, when the male gamete or the female gamete, they fuse together, then they form the zygote. And this zygote now undergoes the process of division and redivision, and that process is called cleavage. And after the cleavage, normally the different stages, like your morula stage is there, then the blastula stage is there, after blastula, then the gastrula stage is there, and after gastrula, in case of human being, there is implantation is there. So implantation occur, and after implantation, the placenta develop, and through the placenta, it receives everything from the mother, and it starts the gestation period. And during this gestation period, normally they receive everything from the mother because they are placental level through the placenta. And after the completion of the gestation period, 280 days, now the young one, they taken birth from the mother. But in case of oviparous animal, it is in case of viviparous, which normally give birth to young one. These are called the viviparous animal. But there are some animals which normally give birth, they normally lay eggs, or the egg-lying animals are called oviparous animals. And what happens to this oviparous animal? Normally, in case of oviparous animal, fertilization occurs in the internal body of the female, and after fertilization, the egg is formed. And the eggs are having calcareous outer covering, and the eggs are normally laid to the outside. And when these eggs are laid to the outside, then there is the incubation period. Normally, in case of hen, the incubation period is normally 21 days. And after 21 days, normally the chicks hatch out of the egg. And when they comes out, and they start moving here and there. So that is why this is the oviparous animal, where the fertilization is internal, but the development is external. So egg development occurs, that process of development here inside the egg, that is also called the embryogenesis. So the embryogenesis of chick and the embryogenesis of human being, these are different, but these are the post-fertilization event. And after that, here the hatching of chick occur, and here normally birth of the young child or the infant occur. So this completes the different events which occur in the sexual reproduction. And we shall study in detail about the sexual reproduction in case of flowering plants separately, and about the human being also separately in the next chapter. Now I hope this video is beneficial for you. If it is really beneficial for you, please like it and subscribe for further videos. Thank you. Thank you very much.